that you decided to be with us here today in Kid City. It's a great day. It's Christmas. I am wearing this hat in honor of my favorite Christmas movie. Do you know what it is? Anybody? Hey, you know what it is? Santa Claus? Santa Claus don't wear this hat. Anybody else? Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. What, Rudolph the Red-Nosed, are you? An elf, bro. Elf. You know? Santa! Yeah, I know him.
Santa here? I know him.
That kind of guy, you know what I'm saying? Anyway, it's Christmas time, and we're having a great time here at Kid City, and we want you to come back and hang out with us and have fun and learn about the Lord and Jesus and the Bible and Moses and Jacob and all those good guys. And David, don't forget David, buddy. He was a good guy. He was one of my favorites. And just love on the Lord and have a good time and worship and do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do, you know, all that good stuff. But anyway, we're so happy you're here. I'm happy. Oh, by the way, I'm Lambden, your old boy Lambden here. In case you're new to this, which you shouldn't be. You should be here at church. But anyway, we're going to have a good time. Let's do some Christmas praise and worship. Are you ready? Let's do it. Oh, here it comes. It's up there. Here it comes. Praise and worship. That was so great. Now I'm so excited because today we're doing a Christmas lesson and it's all about the baby Jesus and stuff, and it's going down right now. So let's do it. Hey, let's see that Christmas video.
Does that song get stuck in your head like it does in mine? Hey, I'm not complaining. In fact, I'm so thankful that we have these words from God to remember the true meaning of Christmas. While it was the shepherds who first heard the news from the angel, they weren't the only ones who went to visit Jesus after he was born. Have you heard of the wise men before? If this is your first time or 100th time hearing this story, I can't wait for you all to see. And pay close attention to the journey the wise men had to worship the newborn king. Let's watch.
Stories of the Bible. Jesus and the wise men. This is Jesus.
Hallelujah!
Jesus is the Son of God who would grow up to do amazing things. His parents on earth were Mary and Joseph.
Hey-o.
Jesus was born in a barn, because there was no room for him anywhere else in Bethlehem. Bethlehem was part of Judea, an area that was ruled by a king named Herod. King Herod was in Jerusalem when some wise men from eastern lands arrived in Jerusalem asking,
"Excuse me,
where is the newborn king of the Jews? We saw his star as it rose and we have come to worship him." When Herod heard that there was another king born in Judea, he was very upset. As was everyone else in Jerusalem.
Yeah, not you.
So Herod called all the important priests and Jews together and asked them where this king was supposed to be born. The Jews knew that their king would eventually come, and it was always told to them that the king of the Jews, the savior of the world, would be born in Bethlehem. So they told that to King Herod. Then King Herod thought of a way to trick the wise men. So he called a private meeting with them and learned from them when the king of the Jews' star first appeared.
Oh, good!
And then King Herod told the wise men, "Go to Bethlehem and search carefully for the child. And when you find him, come back and tell me, so that I can go and worship him too."
Okay.
Hey, on your way.
But secretly, Herod wanted to know where the king of the Jews was so he could get rid of him. So the wise men went on their way, and the star they had seen in the east guided them to Bethlehem. It went ahead of them and stopped over the place where Jesus was, and the wise men were filled with joy.
Woohoo!
They went into the house and saw Mary and Jesus.
Hello!
Oh, look! Wow!
And they bowed down and worshiped Jesus.
Wait,
They gave him special gifts fit for the king that he was, gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then God warned them in a dream to not go home through Jerusalem, where King Herod was, but God told them to go home a different way. So they did. And then an angel appeared to Joseph in a dream and said, "Get up." The angel told Joseph to go to Egypt with Mary and Jesus because Herod was looking to kill Jesus. That very night, Joseph left for Egypt with Jesus and Mary. They stayed in Egypt until Herod was gone, and it was safe for them to go home to Israel. When they returned, an angel warned them about the new ruler of Judea, who was Herod's son.
This way.
So Joseph and his family went to the region of Galilee and found their new home in the town of Nazareth.
Look good?
Yep.
We'll take it.
Where Jesus would grow up and eventually do all the amazing things God had planned for him to do.
Can you imagine the journey those wise men went on to worship Jesus? I mean, King Herod seems like a pretty scary guy, but they did whatever it took to visit Jesus and bring him their gifts. And these weren't any ordinary gifts, were they? The gifts that they brought for Jesus were gifts worthy of giving to a king. The same child that these men worshiped is the same Jesus that we can still worship today, because worship is anything we say, do, or think that gives praise and thanks to God. Friends, that's our big idea for today. I can worship the one true King this Christmas. And Jesus is the reason we celebrate. People have other ideas about what makes Christmas important, but nothing is more important than celebrating Jesus. And it's not just with gifts. Not sure what I mean? Don't worry. I know just the Christmas show to help. Tyler and Caroline are back with another episode of Top 5 Christmas. Let's join them right now and see what they say is the best this Christmas. Listen closely to what they have to say about ways to worship Jesus. Are you ready? Top 5 starts now.
Hey everyone, I'm Tyler.
And I'm Caroline.
And we are the hosts of a little show called Top 5, where we rank anything we can think of to discover the best options out there.
Since it's December, we're gonna spend this month finding all our favorites, from Christmas movies to Christmas carols, and most importantly, Christmas gifts.
And we cannot wait to get into the Christmas spirit with you guys, so let's not waste another second, because Top 5 starts
right now.
So far on Top 5, we've covered our favorite Christmas songs, we've covered our favorite Christmas movies, but today we've got our most exciting episode yet.
Welcome to the Top 5 Christmas Gift Wish List, where
yes,
we rank all the gifts we want most. As a kid, I loved looking at Christmas catalogs and making a list of all the gifts I wanted most. This year is no different.
Exactly. We looked at all the catalogs and gift guides, and we've ranked our most wanted gifts. So it's time for our top five. For number five, plenty of gifts get old, but collectibles never will. For me, I've been adding to my Pokemon collection since I was about 6 years old, and I've never looked back, and oh my gosh, I just got the Evolving Skies booster pack. I'm gonna open this right now.
Okay, well, for me, it's American Girl dolls. Each new addition to my collection is another friend for all my girls, and this year, I got the American Girl Ashlyn doll. So let's go ahead and check it out. She's got a pink little tutu and boots and even a tiara on the side. She is so cute.
I got a Hippopotamus.
That's awesome. Well, let's check out and see what's next on the list for number four.
Coming in at number four, Legos are easily one of the best gifts ever because you can shake the present and you know exactly what's inside before you even open it. Nothing beats that feeling.
Mm-hmm. Let's open it up.
Let's do it.
Yes! The Lego Marvel Avengers Advent Calendar!
Wow, I got the Star Wars Mandalorian Advent Calendar. Wow, we are already 3 weeks into December, so we'll have to catch up.
Mm-hmm. Let's pop them open. Oh, Oh, so you get pieces in each one.
Oh, I think I got a little R2 or something.
I think I got Black Widow too.
Oh my favorite. Goodness. Wow, this was an extremely exciting gift, but I want to see what's next. So let's check it out.
For number three, games are the gift that keep on giving. You could play them for hours and hours, long after Christmas has come and gone.
Absolutely, and this year, I finally got Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. It's one of the only Zelda games I haven't played yet, so this gift is perfect for me.
Mine's much better. As for me, I got the Super Mario 3D World. I played Super Mario Odyssey endlessly, and I need more Mario in my life.
Everyone does. Mario is the best. I cannot wait to play these video games, but I cannot wait to see what's next. Let's check it out.
And coming in at number two on our list,
hoverboards.
Hoverboards are an amazing gift because they're a lot of fun and they're a great way to get around. Can't wait to ride this bad boy.
I love this thing.
And I even got a pink one.
Mine's black. Oh, this is awesome.
Okay, well, we're gonna check out if Tyler's okay, but in the meantime, let's check out number one. And coming in at number one, you know what it is?
Yes, I do.
What gift is better than money? Mm-hmm. You can spend it on whatever you want or save it in your piggy bank.
In anticipation of all the money that I'm gonna get this year for Christmas, I bought this sweet Make It Rain money launcher. You wanna see a little demonstration?
I would love to.
Check it out. Oh, yeah! Money, money, money! Dollar bills, y'all! Dollar, dollar bills, y'all! Check it out, check it out! Oh, man, that was awesome, but it'll be even better once I have more money. I mean, everything will be better once I have more money!
Well, I don't know about that. Money doesn't solve everything.
Well, okay. We should pick this up, though.
Okay.
All right. Maybe we got a little bit carried away today, especially with the Make It Rain money launcher. The truth is, this happens every year. I get so preoccupied with what gifts that I want, and in the end, it overshadows everything else about Christmas.
Yeah, gifts are really a lot of fun and a great way to show our love for our friends and family. I mean, the wise men traveled a long way just to bring gifts to the newborn king after all. But the gifts aren't the most important part of Christmas. The child the wise men brought the gifts for is.
Exactly, and I've always wondered why they brought presents. And the truth is, it was really an act of worship. When that star appeared in the sky, they had traveled so far just so they could worship the one who was born King of the Jews. They brought gifts worthy of a king to Jesus because they believed the truth about who Jesus was and why he was born. They didn't even know everything about Jesus, but they understood that his birth was an incredibly important event. The Savior of the world had arrived in the form of a child. What gift is greater than that?
Yeah, presents can help spread joy during Christmas, but we should always make sure that that joy connects back to the true meaning of our celebration, Jesus's birth.
Right, and we can express our gratitude to God during Christmas and the rest of the year by worshiping Jesus. Because worship is all about putting God first and celebrating him. It's anything we say, do, or even think about that gives praise and thanks to God.
What's cool is we can worship God in so many different ways. Really, anything you do can be an act of worship. For example, when you're decorating the house and preparing for Christmas morning, you could think about why Christmas is important and say thank you to God for sending Jesus at Christmas.
Yep, me and my family do that every year. Or you could even go Christmas caroling, or when you hear a Christmas song like Joy to the World or Silent Night, or even the First Noel, pay close attention to the words. These songs talk about Jesus in the very first Christmas. You can sing them to Jesus as a way of worship and praise to him.
And you can read the Christmas story in the Bible with your family. That's a great way to help you remember why Christmas is so special.
It really is a lot of fun thinking about the different ways we can worship Jesus this Christmas. Well, friends, we've got just one more episode of Top 5 for you, and it's one of my personal favorites, Sweet Treats, one of the best parts of the holidays. We're very excited about it.
Yeah, so we'll see you back here next week with our final episode. And until then, Merry Christmas.
Bye, guys.
Okay, so I have been there. There was a time when I thought gifts were the main reason for Christmas, but that is so far from the truth. The whole reason for gifts is to remember the gift that God gave us that first Christmas, his son, Jesus. And I loved hearing the different ways to worship Jesus. Maybe there was a way to worship Jesus that you hadn't thought of before. Just remember, whatever you do this Christmas, think about Jesus and thank God for this truly amazing gift. Well, friends.
Man, what a great day this has been. Man, I just want to tell you guys that I'm so glad that you came here today, because sometimes it gets lonely hanging out in this studio. But listen, I'm glad you're here, and we want you to come back on campus. Two services, 8:30 and 10:30. We're going to put it right up here. Is it up there? Yeah, 8:30 and 10:30 here at Kid City. You have a great Christmas and a great day. God bless, and we'll see you next week here at Kid City.
Habanera from the opera Carmen by French composer Georges Bizet. On behalf of everyone here at WXYZ Public Radio, have a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Y'all come back now. Here,